Hi everyone, welcome to our virtual training session. This week is focusing on balancing, coordination, strength, and equilibrium. So today I have Adari Dayak with us. She's gonna do the high energy and harder, more difficult stuff on the balance pillow. These are great because it you can just get them and put them anywhere in your house or on the lawn or out front. We're using tennis shoes today, but they are safe to put your cleats on and it won't pop them. They're very durable and they last a long time. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna start off with just some basic routines, and I'm gonna do the simple, you know, generic on the ground flat stuff, and Adari is gonna do the stuff on the balance pillow, and that's gonna be a little bit more difficult. So our first one today, we're gonna just balance on one foot. Okay, we're gonna put one foot on the training tube, balance pillow, and you're gonna do some heel drops. So you're just working on your knee, your proprioception of your knee, and you're gonna drop down 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Much harder on the pillow. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, and then rest, shake it out a little bit. Really important to shake it out so that your muscles are loose. Then you're gonna switch. Let's go on the right foot, or the opposite foot. What I want you to notice is this muscle right here is the one that should be firing along with your ligaments around your knee. So as we go and we dip, you'll see that it starts to shake a little bit, and that's what you want. You want it to be difficult. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. You should get some burn and stuff in your quads and your glutes, right?
Feels good.
Feels good. Okay, Adari's gonna do her next one. This is really good for injury prevention.
All right, next one is forward, backward, sideways. We're gonna do right and left. I'm just gonna show you a quick example. You can do this on the ground or on the bubble. What you're gonna do, one foot's planted. Make sure your knee is always bent. Do not have it straight all the way. More bent, the better. Even the lower you get, the more you're working your muscles. And you're balancing, and you're gonna move your other leg forward, nice and slow and controlled, backwards, and then sideways. And you're just gonna keep repeating that until you reach 10 times total. All right, once you're finished with that, you're gonna switch to your other leg and do the same thing.
Forward, nice and slow, right?
Nice and slow, do not make it quick.
Sideways.
Wanna be controlled the whole time.
Forward. Back, sideways. Okay, get 10 reps of those and make sure that you're isolating, focusing on those muscles around your kneecap and the ligaments. If they're shaking, that's a good thing. You want them to be counterbalancing yourself as you're going along. Hopefully, if you don't have a balance pillow, you can order them from us online, but also you can put together like a sweatshirt or something.
Yeah, a sweatshirt or a blanket. If you just put it in a pile. Yeah. And just stand on it. It's also working your muscles a little bit more than standing on a flat surface.
Yeah, so this is easy, beginner. That's advanced. Somewhere in between would be a towel or a pile of, you know, sweats or something. Okay, so our next one, we are going to work on a little bit of balancing. And this is our takeoff. So we want to make sure that we can get our coordination and our balance right. If you've done some personal training with me or Adari, you realize that this is a really important element for your body and for your mind. We want you to get on one foot, keep your knee bent, stay focused on something on the grass, put your arms out like you're gonna take off and fly. Don't be afraid to have yourself balancing, but try to balance yourself out. You will get wobbly. Get your heel up towards your hips. Try to keep your hips straight. That'll make you rebalance. And then once you feel good, try to look forward. So you're taking your focus off of the grass now, and you're actually trying to keep balance on one foot. Okay, so let's see if you can do that on the balance pillow.
All right.
Good, knee bent. Arms out. Focus on a grass point in front of you. Straight arms, try to get them out like a cross. Now get your heel up. Try to get your heel up. This is the hard part. Can you get your heel up a little higher? Keep your hips straight. Lean forward, lean forward, lean forward, lean forward. You can get your heel up towards your head. Then come back down, slowly, slowly if you can. Save it, slowly, slowly, slowly. And good. That's how you do it. So do that with your right foot, and then try to do it with your left foot. Take, you know, a couple of reps here and a few minutes to get that done. It'll take you a little bit of time. Okay, our next one that we're gonna move on to is that you're gonna need a ball. Okay, we're just gonna use a simple, pull the trailer up so we can have something. We don't have a ball up here, but you can use anything. Use a table, you can use your garage, you can use anything that you have that can be set up for a wall. So our first one is just gonna be a simple on one leg. You're going to throw it and catch it. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. You'll be a little bit harder on the balance wheel. Then you're going to switch sides. Once again, now this is going towards having to look up. Like on our last one, you had to look up a little bit, and that makes it more difficult to balance when you're not looking at the ground. And in soccer, we always have our eyes on something, whether it's a cross, whether it's a defender, whether it's the ball. You're not really looking at the ground and focusing on where you're standing. So this proprioception work will help you understand the relationship between your body and the ground.
And you can do this with a partner too.
Sure, partner. If we do it with a partner.
If you don't have a wall.
You can do it with one. I've got the ball, so you're both on one. And I'm just gonna bounce it, and you're gonna catch. Bounce and catch. Bounce and catch. Now, once again, we're keeping your eyes off the ground, and you're trying to keep yourself balanced at the same time. Switch. Good. It's much more difficult on the balance pillow. It's like 10 times a workout, maybe 20 times a workout. Okay. Try not to put your foot down. Save it if you can. Don't put your hand down. Save it, because that's when your body's fighting against everything. All right. So that, go for a couple of minutes and do that.
And then I got one.
Okay.
You don't need a partner for this. You just need a soccer ball and some balance. And what you're going to do is just balance on one foot, throw the ball on the ground, and catch. All right? Keep your balance. Keep your knee bent. And let's do that 10 times, and then switch to the other foot.
I like it.
Yeah.
So now, concentrating on if you have a balance pillow, if you have a balled up, wad of socks or a, towel, or stand on your cat?
No.
No? Okay. We're going to try to balance, and we're going to kick it to yourself. 10 of those. Two.
It's not hard.
Here.
Whoa.
Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Oh man. Eight. Okay, get to 10 and then switch feet and do the other side. Okay, so now that we've done that, my calves are already burning.
Mm-hmm.
Right here.
Feel it.
Right there. Okay, so now we've got the balance pillow and you've got your wall. Maybe you want to give yourself a little bit of room. This is a little bit flexible, so it's not going to bounce back that hard, so I'm a little bit closer. So we want to do the same thing, but we're going to volley it and catch. Okay? Keep your balance. Whoa. Volley, catch. Keep your balance. Fight it.
Oh.
All right, you too.
I'll take your pillow. Or bubble or whatever.
Balance pillow.
Balance pillow.
Kick it harder than that.
Yeah, I do.
There you go. Perfect. Excellent. Nice. Good. All of this, while she's wobbling, you can see like her muscles are flexing, and you can see it's like
spazzing. That's a good thing. That means your body's fighting against its own weight. And then think about this. You really need to own your own body weight. If you're fighting for somebody with somebody in the box, whoever has the core strength and the ability to fight and own that territory is going, it comes from here, right? You're always on one foot. You're leaning into somebody, right? You're kicking a ball, you're shooting a ball, you're always running off of one foot. So it's always one foot. So all of our training, we want to make sure that we're doing everything on one foot and isolating those muscles that we're training to be dominant while you're on one foot. Okay, so that's good. 10 reps on that, 10 on that. Now we're going to just take away the pillow, and you're going to use your head, but we're going to be flat. So grab that haircut, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, maybe even longer. So we're going to have 2 feet, and we're going to just throw the ball and hit it. Throw the ball and hit it. Throw the ball and hit it. And hit it. So we're snapping into it. Okay, we're going to do 10 like that, and then you're going to take your time, get a rest, and then you're going to do 10 where you're actually snapping with one leg. So you're on one leg, and you're pushing. One leg, and push. I want that heel to come up so you're forcing like a cobra snake. You're snapping into the ball. Bring that heel up. All right, 10 of those, and then rest and relax. And then we'll take a little breather, and then we'll do something onto the next group. In the meantime, we're going to show you a couple of different players that have come out here and trained before the COV 19. So we had some players out here on the ranch, and we're doing some workouts and stuff like that. So we'll take a few peeks at what they're doing and how they're doing it. All right, be right back.
Good, Haley. Okay, heal up, Ari. Okay.
She was physically forgotten, and she slipped into my pocket with my car keys. She said, "You're taking me for granted, cause I please you. When he's down.
Yes.
As if everybody knows what I'm talking about. As if everybody here would know exactly what I was talking about. Talk about diamonds on the soles of this shoe.
A lot of it goes into service. See, I have good service.
He makes the side of a wave.
Right?
Poor boy changes clothes and puts on aftershave.
Good rest, stay on that too. Don't put your toe down, let's have her put your toe down.
She said, "Honey, take me dancing," and they ended up sleeping in a doorway. In the bodegas and the lights on Upper Broadway. Wearing diamonds on the soles of their shoes.
Airplane mode.
And I can say, woo.
Yes, I like that. It's good, solid.
Everybody here was great. Focus. I was talking about.
Nice.
I mean, everybody here knows exactly what I was talking about. Talking about that.
This would be good for you, Britt. You're so tall. The video's got a timer on it, too, so you'll be able to see how long you guys can make it for. If you're wobbling, it's a good thing. We just want to start straightening it out.
People say I'm crazy. I got diamonds on my soles and my shoes. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's one way to lose these walking blues. Diamonds on the soles of my shoes.
Oops. Nice job.
All right, welcome back. We're gonna get busy on our next assignment. So what we're looking for now is a little bit of a juggle off. You guys know at practice, each week, at least once a month, we're always doing a juggle off at the practice at the beginning. So make sure that you're nice and good and loose. We just did the pillow exercises. We did the heading. We did the balancing, the core strength stuff. And now we wanna see you guys juggle. And this will be fun because this will be our first interactive juggle off. You guys will have 8 minutes. Okay, when we say go, you'll have 8 minutes to juggle. If you drop the ball, you come back in front of your camera and you watch to see who the last player left is. And the last player standing, still juggling on camera, will get a prize. I think it's gonna be a West Coast shirt with some bling rhinestones on it, something unique and custom that's never been done before. So we'll show you more of that later. So first of all, we want to get you guys back out and starting to get ready to juggle. We also want to thank our sponsors for today with the NorCal Fire and DiExtend Sports with West Coast Soccer. And Adari, what do you have?
We have a lot of social media outlets. We have Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, and TikTok. So make sure you log on to our campfire site. Campsite for West Coast, and
you were thinking
click on
Squidward campfire site.
I was thinking of the song.
I knew it.
The campfire song. Make sure you log into the or click on those links and subscribe and like all of our social media outlets to stay connected with West Coast and stay connected with each other.
All right, guys, here we go. Let's get to work.